Saves those who are crushed in spirit. At this event, we want to sympathize with Desmond and his immediate family with the loss of his wife, and we thank God that everyone present bears that moment with them in their heart. The opening prayer we are asked our brother up there, Brother Gallant, just to come up. Because of our time constraint, and we want to sort of move timelessly through the program and ask everyone just to cooperate. God bless us. Amen.
Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, we come before thee in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the light of the world, the first and the last, the ever-living, loving arms of this bereaved family. We pray, Lord, that you will come and comfort this family. Keep them in the palm of your hand, because surely they are the apex of your creation. We thank you, Lord, for this day that you've created in our lives. Though our hearts may be overwhelmed, though our hearts, O Lord, may be tired of what has happened, but in the end, we know that you have all the answers. We pray, Father, that you will be with this service. For him that will bring the word, Father, may, O Lord, it be an unadulterated word. May it be an unwatered word, Father. May surely, Father, that the preacher have heard from the throne room of God to comfort the sore hearts, the sorrow and the bereavement. Come, Lord, and be our portion, be our guide, and be our strength. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Well, I was just thinking aloud as that life is interrupted at many occasions. When I heard the passing on of Jorita, I believe everyone's life was interrupted. We should have been somewhere else today, and yet today we are at the funeral of someone that sort of timelessly moved on with life, out of time into eternity. I was thinking about this, that many a times that we think it's just the death of a person that takes place, but death is just a portion of what eternity allows us to enter in. And for this purpose, I need to say that we all need to reclaim the time and ensure that our life is timelessly prepared before we leave it in this part. We're going to stand and sing the hymn on our pamphlet, Amazing Grace. Let us just stand while we sing it.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound, has saved a wretch like me. I was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Was
an encouragement again to the family, which I take solely to my heart, is that in Revelations chapter 21 it says, "He will wipe away every tear from the eyes. There shall be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain. The old order of things has passed away." A profound promise of comfort and hope. It reflects on the future of our suffering. I want to ask, on our program we've got here, a minute of silence for many reasons that we probably ponder on this week. For many reasons that we ponder upon as to the wise and what the reason behind it. I've given Desmond, my brother, a portion of scripture in Isaiah 57. It says, sometimes we wonder why people pass on early in life, and some suddenly in life, and we stand profound at the undertakings of God, how He does things. And the answer to that is many times the reason for sudden death in people's life, or death that's unplanned, is that he saves them from things yet to come in life. Troubles, events that would have disturbed us much more. So he removes us from the equation, and the pain that we would have suffered back then would not be as great as what we have. So let us just have this moment of silence, respecting, and a song for 3 minutes. I think there's someone that needs to bring about the song. They've got it on the program, a 1 minute song for 3 minutes, 1,000 reasons, if they've still got it on.
Worship your holy name. The sun.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We're going to ask Stephen Bowe to come up front. He's going to do his portion. As God has laid upon his heart. Amen.
Morning, everybody. It's funny, you can go around the world, dodge bullets, go into unnamed terrains, and nothing prepares you for something like this. My name's Stephen. Just a little story. I just came back from Mozambique, and everyone told me it's raining, storming, South Africa, Cape Town's raining, P's raining, like, okay, great. As a kid, I used to, especially when my grandfather passed, I used to walk from school, and it would rain, and tears would come down, and no one could see because it's raining. So when everyone said it's raining, I'm like, great, no one can see the tears. And anyway, I'm here today, it's sunshine and roses. Dear friends and family, today we gather to honor the life of my beloved mother, Tjerita. She was born in Cape Town, South Africa, and she was a woman of immense strength, faith, and love. Just a month ago, we celebrated her 60th birthday, cherishing every moment together. With those who know her, well, obviously everyone knows her here, she was known for her tenacity, her unwavering faith, and a love for her family. She was always ready to help others, offering support and guidance wherever it was needed. A smile could light up a room, and her presence will be deeply missed by all who knew her. Mom's life was a testament to her faith and a love for her family. She fought bravely against stage 4 pancreatic cancer. Never losing her spirit or her love for life. Her strength and determination was an inspiration for us all. As we say goodbye today to my mom, I'm reminded of the words of Isaiah 43:18, which states, "Forget the former things and do not dwell in the past." My mom lived a forward-looking spirit type of life, always focused on the present and the future. She embraced each day with faith and courage, never allowing the challenges she faced to define her. Mom, you live these words out every single day. You taught us to let go of the past, to cherish the memories that we share, and to always look ahead with hope and optimism. Your strength, faith, and love will continue us as we move forward without you. One of my fondest memories was when my mother's first grandson was born, Nathaniel. Incidentally, on her birthday, the 2nd of March, 2016. When she heard the news, the first flight she could get, she rushed to the hospital. She rushed to the hospital to meet him. She loved him dearly. They would fight continuously till probably last month, always reprimanding him. But he'll still find solace by going and laying in her arms and saying, "I love you, Grandma." Before I carry on, I would like to acknowledge just a few people. To my dad, who held her hand and was by her side throughout the late nights, the early mornings, warming her beanbag, to many distances for her treatment. and not once complaining. Dad, you've shown us what true responsibility is and what real love looks like. Till today, you're standing strong and composed, and thank you. Before I carry on, just some outsiders that came in and became family. Chevy, your support the last year has been beyond what was required. Many days you would make sure mom was comfortable. You would take her to the hairdresser, take her for shopping, and do all the girly things. Your family has also been a great blessing. Abraham and Melanie, you've opened your doors and you've spent special occasions with us. You've welcomed us into your lives and your home, and I thank you for that. Nadia, unfortunately you couldn't make it today, but we noticed immediately how much you cared for our family. Your vibrant spirit and kindness is a real testament to us all that love is not just in blood, but can be forged over bonds too. Thank you for taking mom on walks. Thank you for cooking for mom and dad, especially in days we were not there. And thank you for helping out with the kids when I was away. Come here, DJ. You did your part. Myself and Chess were not always around as we would like to have been. And you were there when dad really needed you. Mom's only wish is for you to be a success and a blessing to others. You were her baby, and she always had a soft spot for you. So thank you for being there. Saving the best for last year. Cheers, Nick. No one would know what you went through this last year, except the people that were with you. Your unwavering love, determination, and immense sacrifice gave us more time with our mother. You are a second child, and I firsthandly witnessed her incredible resilience and determination embodied in you. You sacrificed much to ensure she received the best care possible, a reflection of the deep love and admiration you have for her. Carry on being as strong as you have been. To the extended family, thank you for this past week, for the closure, the prayers, the leadership, and the unity. I ask that the family continue in this path, as this was always my mom's desire. Life is short. I know we feel that it can be mundane at times, but in this last year has taught me anything, is not just by my mom's condition, is that life can be over in the blink of an eye. We take for granted the time that we have. We live and dwell on what was, what have been, and what we wanted, instead of embracing the present of what is, what we have, and what we need. Unfortunately, I cannot mention everybody, but I'm grateful for your love and support that we received. Mom, your memory will forever be etched in our hearts. We will miss your presence, your laughter, and your unwavering love. You lived a vibrant life, zealous for those who know you, with a kind heart. Every challenge you faced, you overcome. When mountains were in your way, you made sure you climbed over it. Your legacy lives in the hearts of your children and your family, who I would think are kind and compassionate individuals, a true testament of your love and your guidance. Your spirit will continue to inspire us to live with generosity and kindness and love. As I end off today, I want to remind you of a scripture called in Matthew 5 that states, "Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted." We find comfort in knowing that you are in a better place and you are at peace, and that your memory will forever be a source of strength and inspiration to us. We cherish every moment we spent with you, and we will miss you dearly. And I thank you.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. I'm standing here and I'm thinking aloud. When moms go, I'm more concerned about dad that is left behind. I come through a family where my mom left us through death. I looked at my dad and he was more alone than ever before. And I pray that the situation where there's three sons in the house, that we're leaving dad behind. And I pray that leaving dad behind, that same affection, love, tolerance, desire to see him happy, be pursued. Mother's Day is coming up soon, and I've always witnessed in the shopping malls how it's overcrowded with children shopping for moms. When it gets to Dad's Day, they don't shop around. It doesn't bother them. And we should have that same affection towards our dads. Amen. Looking at Desmond, he's not someone that talks. He's not someone that shows signs. He's quiet, withdrawn, but there's pain. And that pain we need to sort of identify with attention to. We've got the youngest son, DJ, who's going to say his final goodbye.
Sorry. Hi everyone. Can you guys hear me talking? Okay, so thank you everybody for coming. I just wanted to say something about my mom. My name is DJ. I'm the youngest in the family of the brothers of my mom's children. I love my mom very much. She meant a lot to me, and especially over the past year, I'd like to think I've made her more proud than previous years. But yeah, I'd like to start. To be overlooked. Despite enduring our shared, our fair share of adversaries, our bond has also been adorned with moments of profound joy. With all due respect to others, I unequivocally assert that my mother, in my eyes, epitomizes unparalleled greatness, reflecting on her. I find no equal, except perhaps maybe my girlfriend. I'm just kidding. My mother's tutelage has imbued in me like invaluable principles, both humane and spiritual, surpassing anybody else's influence. She's instilled in me a profound sense of gratitude and pride for the life bestowed upon me, imparting lessons on gentlemanly conduct, respect, and unparalleled a steadfast devotion to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Though I had intended to share a particular story, maybe even a memory of her remains that I do cherish. I cherish every memory I had with Mom. Among the myriads of gifts she's bestowed upon me, her teachings resonate with me profoundly. She's ingrained in me the prioritizing of the divine in all endeavors, and the essence of love. Her guidance steered me along the path of righteousness, and as a journey I intend to honor. During my journalistic pursuits, she reveled in pursuing of my works. She admired my writing, because my writing is usually based in truth and also controversy. She always advocated for the wisdom of life's navigation, because she always taught me, like Proverbs especially. She directed me to the book of Proverbs every time I made a mistake in life, because it really is just a book full of wisdom. And she just wanted me to be wise. My comprehension of her significance is just, I could never put into words how special my mom was, but I will undoubtedly say she was the best, and there is no comparison. Her devout love to Jesus transcends all bounds. She exemplifies unwavering commitment. Every moment spent together was a very cherished occasion by me and also my brothers, and especially my dad. From celebrating my milestones to even embracing my imperfections, her love knew no conditions. There would be times I'd make her upset, but she would forgive me. My mom taught me the meaning of unconditional love and what it actually means. And I can say that I've only experienced it from my mom and my dad. And for me, that's the greatest thing of all, because I understand the importance of it and why it's actually so special. And my mom was special. Beyond her maternal role, she was my confidant. She was a sage of wisdom who often humbled my perceived intellect in her own ways, of course. It's like I was playing checkers and my mom's playing chess. We're not playing the same thing. My mom's on a different level to what I am. And it took a long time for me to realize that, and I wish I realized it sooner. She embodied the epitome of virtue and all that is good. In conclusion, I affirm that my mother is unequivocally the best and also the greatest, apart from Jesus, of course. My mother reigns supreme in her greatness. To bear the title of Charita Bose's son is a privilege beyond measure. To you, my dearest mother, I profess my eternal love and gratitude, and I thank you for everything that you've taught me in life. I'll never forget anything, and I'll try to make you proud for the rest of my life. Thank you so much, everybody, for listening to me. And I hope you all enjoy the rest of the day. Thank you.
Okay. Call upon the grandson, Nathaniel. He's got a poem that he's going to read.
Hello, everybody. I'm Charita Bose's grandson. My name's Nate. I would like to read a poem for her. For the people in tears, the Lord's still there with you. My grandma's spirit's still watching you guys. But I'm going to get to read my poem now. Dear Grandma, up above the sky, I miss you more than words can say. Your hugs and kisses, oh so sweet. In my heart, they will always stay. You taught me things and you made me smile. You are my sunshine every day. I'll cherish all the memories we shared and remember you in every way. Though you are no longer here with me, I feel your love so warm and near. Goodbye for now, dear grandma of mine. In my heart, you'll forever be my dear. Thank you, everybody, for listening. I appreciate your kindness.
Hallelujah. Powerful words. Amen. In the program that we're going to bring about, instead of going directly over to ministry, we're going to continue with the other aspects of the program. We're going to ask Maria to bring about tribute.
Good morning, everybody. I just want to greet you all in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, because I have to greet you in that manner, because this woman that I know that we're talking about this morning, that we, the person that the life we're celebrating, is a person that I know that loved Jesus, and Jesus was the number one and the first and most important person in her life. You know, for me to have 3 minutes to talk about Jorita is not possible. So I wrote something down as a tribute to Jorita. I met Jorita through DJ and my son, Shaw. They were schooling in grade standard six, is grade eight. They met each other in grade eight at Bryland School. And when he met DJ, he came home and he said, "Mommy, oh, I met this wonderful person." And he always wanted me to meet DJ. But when he met Auntie Jorita, he said, "Mom, I've met somebody just like you. She's talking and she's forever praising and she always wanted to have the last say. And we know Jorita like that." So I met Jorita's family and Jorita met my family. And my sister-in-law said to me, "Maria, you've met your match. There's even a person that wanted to have the last say above you, but that was Jorita to me. She was a vibrant, vibrant person. She was my friend. You know, the one thing that I remembered about Jorita when I met her, she said, "Maria, I'm not into friends. I'm not that girl that have got this friends relationship and that. And I'm usually in a person's life just for a season." And then I look at her and I thought, "Girl, I'm also that girl that's not into friendship." But never that we know that God put us together for that season that she was talking about and for that friendship. Because we need somebody that when we go through trials and tribulations, and we're not going to make it if we didn't have any trials and tribulations, we needed that one person that we know that prayed us through, that guided us through, that said, "Maria, I have a situation like you, do this." But she always brought God back into our situations. You know, 3 minutes, like I said, all the things that me and Jorita went through, we went to, it was a Natis, his mother's baby shower, and me and Jorita decided that we're taking the car. Desmond just bought her that car, and Derek and Desmond didn't go with us. It's the first time, because we all know Jorita and Desmond's always together when they go on trips. We decided that we're going on this trip, and we were so scared because it was just two ladies that's now going to Durban. And there was a time when we have to save now on this trip, né? And Jorita said, "Wait, we put in the navigator that we're not going to pay all the store gates." That navigator took us the long way, and we used more money to with that long way that we drove. And I said, "Jorita, I think put back the toll gates on this navigator so that we can get to Durban, because we need to get there before the party started." You know, and another thing the road took us such a long way that the green grasses, I remember me and Jorita, there was a road. It was green on the one side, green on the other side, and the road was just going through. And I said to Jorita, "Hey, this heaven must be like this. Look how beautiful." You know that, I don't know if you wrote that part of Solicitor 2 when you just passed. When you go to Durban, we wrote there and we were just looking and we were crying, and she said, "Maria, just stop talking, we must pray because we need to have Jesus on this road, because it's just us two ladies." There was another time when we rode and there was only like the red light went on the speedometer, on the petrol light went on, and we were in this road, and then she said to me, I was panicking. I said, "Jorita, we're not going to make it to the nearest fuel station." She said, "Man, Desmond said, if this light go on, there's still 100 kilometers. So we trust God for this 100 kilometers. You know what happened that day? In the middle of nowhere, there was no cars that we drove. There was we don't know where the police car came from. Out of nowhere, God sent that police car, because you know, in life now, we can't stop anybody to ask for guidance and directions as ladies. So the police car was there, and they drove us all the way to, when the policeman saw that, he said, "What are you two girls doing? How can you drive alone?" And you know how far the police station were. Jurithu said, "Listen here, it's not just two of us, there's three persons, because she knows who her trust, who her faith, who she believes in, and who she depends on." And like I said, I met Jorita through DJ. The boys were always sleeping at Jorita's house. And then at night when I was worried about my son because he's my only son. I had this knowledge that he's at Jerita's house. I don't need to fear. I don't need to be worried. I could just go to sleep. Because Charlotte always told me, Mommy, you don't have to worry when I'm at Jerita's house. This woman can pray. I think even the devil is scared when Jerita starts praying. So you can rest assured when I'm there and trust that I'm in good hands. And Charlie can't be. He's out of the country, but he's sending his condolences statement. I just want to read what I wrote to Jerita. Even facing life's final challenge, Jerita's strength and grace were evident. She confronted life with illness. She confronted her illness with the same dignity and courage that she demonstrated throughout her life. This final chapter, while difficulty, was a true testament to her extraordinary character and resilience. As we bid farewell to Jerita, let us not only grieve her absence, but also celebrate the richness of the life she lived. Let us honor her memory by embodying the virtues she exemplified, by living each day with purpose, by nurturing the relationship we cherish, and by making a positive impact on our way. Jerita, your physical presence will be profoundly missed, but your spirit remains a guiding force in our lives. Your legacy of love, wisdom, kindness is a treasure that we will carry forward. In our hearts, your memories will forever resonate with love and gratitude. Rest in peace, beloved Jerita. You have left an incredible mark on our lives, and your spirit will continue to inspire us for all our days. We are deeply saddened by your loss, but grateful for the time we spent together. My beloved friend, you may have left us far too soon, but your loving presence will endure forever in our hearts and soul. We will keep the memory of you alive by cherishing the moment that we spent together and remember your legacy always. We honor and cherish you. May your spirit live on forever in our hearts and soul. Rest in peace, my beloved friend. You are gone, but you will never be forgotten. You know, this verse resonates so profoundly with Jerita, 2 Timothy 4, verse 7. You have fought the good fight. You have finished the race. You have kept the faith, and you have remained faithful. And I know a crown is a crown of righteousness which the Lord have laid and is awaiting for you. Goodbye, my friend.
Okay, and it's coming to close almost. Heidi Onaus.
Good morning, everyone. I want to greet you in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. I want to thank Uncle Desmond and the boys for giving me this honor to speak of your mom. My name is Heidi Onaus. I'm a very dear friend. Jerita was a dear friend to me. Jerita never called me Heidi. She called me sis. And I've learned so much from her. Most of my delicious dishes, cakes, she taught me. Everyone know, yeah, she can cook. And she was a great cook. Jerita's name means the J for jolly, the U for upstanding, the R for love for others, the E, slight you make others happy. The T is for talent hidden or not. The H is hand that always give, and I think she's given to many of us today. We are a testament of it. And the A, is for adorable and precious. Today I'm not wearing black, as it's the norm to wear black to a funeral, but to me, Jerita was a bunch of flowers. She was always jolly, always cheerful, always encouraging. She was a very happy person. She never spoke bad of no one. She always said, sis, we're gonna pray. We're gonna pray this through. And I've learned so much strength from her. Jerita had a contagious laugh. When she laughed, everyone around her will laugh with her. Churita's greatest birthday gift was when Nathaniel was born on her birthday. And she never stops talking about Nathaniel. She loved Uncle Desmond. He was the love of her life. She loved the boys. She always spoke about Stephen, DJ, Chesney. There wasn't a day she wouldn't mention you guys and how she prayed for you and your partners. Churita loved my girls. And I would tell her the funniest things of them or the naughtiest stuff, and she would laugh about it. Churita loved God. We never had a conversation where she didn't talk about God. Every day she would tell me something about God. A few weeks ago, I've lost my mom. I didn't know Churita was so ill. Churita encouraged me and she apologized for not being with me. And last week, Churita always told me she's going to doctor, she's going to hospital, but I never knew she was so ill. Last week when Uncle Desmond found me, we went to visit her, and when I saw her, I burst out crying. And I asked her, can I pray for you? And she said, yes. I first asked her, do you know who I am? And she said, sis, I haven't lost my mind. And we were laughing about it. And in her pain, she looked so beautiful. She was a very beautiful person, and I will always remember that. Churita, I love you, my friend. Salute till we meet again in the morning.
Was the gesund? The mom and then
good morning, everybody. Greet you all in the wonderful name of Jesus. Desmond and the sons and the rest of the family. Allow me to do my, in Afrikaans, is it all right with everybody? Is it? Thank you very much. Ja, ik het, Churita op 'n wonderlike manier geontmoet. En sy het aan my kom soek, sy het my iewers gesien. En sy en Desmond het my kom soek. En ek het so geskrik toe ek nou hulle in die kerk, in ons kerk, in Elsies Rivier in Kaapstad, na my toe kom. Weet u, daar het net iets tussen ek en Churita gebeur. Hulle sê toe vir my, hulle is die wat my gebel het, hulle is die persoon wat my gebel het, en so aan. En die oomblik toe ek in sy mekaar hak, het daar net iets wonderlik gebeur tussen ons. Ek het met baie mense persoonlike verhoudinge en vriendskappe, maar sy was net anders in my lewe. Ek is 'n suster gesoon van Kaapstad en baie noem my Auntie Mona. As jy nou wonder, waar pas sy nou in? Maar vir my was sy 'n verskriklike wonderlike mens. Weet u, Die Sondag na kerk het ek nie tot rust gekom nie. Ek het haar verkeerd verstaan, Desmond. Ek het gedink jy het in 'n hotel in Sensory City ingeboek. En ek sê vir my dogter, vat my na haar toe, na Auntie Jurita toe. Ek wil met haar sit en gesels. Daar het net iets wonderlik tussen ek en hierdie vrou gebeur. En ek wou nie eet nie. En sy sê vir my, mama, maar julle het ons die afspraak Dinsdag gemaak. Ek sê nee, vat my nou na haar toe. Ek het van die een hotel in Sensory City gegaan na die ander hotel. So desperaat was ek om haar meer van haar te weet. En weet jy, en ons het maar teleurgesteld teruggekom en dit lyk ek kon nie wag tot die Dinsdag toe nie. Die Dinsdag het ons by mekaar gekom en by my huis. En ons het so wonderlik getyd gehad, saam gebid. Weet jy, sy het so groot liefde gehad vir die Here. Wat my regtig verbaas het. En dit was vir my uitstaande. Die Here was Jurita se begin en haar einde. Weet jy, onlangs reël ek 'n konferensie in Vredenburg, wat ek vanmiddag moet bywoon. En ek wil net hierdie tema vir ons allemaal 'n boodskap nalaat. Die vrou wat die konferensie reël in Vredenburg, vra vir my, wat sal die tema van die dag wees? Ek sê vir haar, sal die tema Amos 4 vers 12 klaar moet. En ek sit nou in bepeinter en hierdie naas over hierdie thema gaat, maar jou paar om jou God te ontmoet. En ek dink ek het nooit geweet, dit sal hierdie selfde dag ook haar begrafnis wees nie. Ek wil die thema van hierdie konferensie gebruik vandag by haar, by hierdie wonderlike vrou se begrafnis, om vir ons te sê, maak ons klaar om ons God te ontmoet. Wanneer hierdie tydelike liggaam met die ewige verwissel word. Dit is die belangrikste oomblik wat plaasvind. Vanaf die lewe tot die dood, die oorgang. En vir my die wonderlikste van alles is, hy is die woord van die Here sê in Tessalonisense, hy sê ons sal hulle wat in Christus ontslaap het, hoegenaamd nie voorwees nie. En ek dank die Here vir 'n vrou soos hierdie. Nêrens in 'n gesprek, ek was ook onlangs deel van haar 60ste verjaarsdag, daar in Simonstown, iewers, was ons daar. En ek was so bevoorreg om daar saam te wees. Maar ek het gevra, Here, wat sou ek graag vir haar kinders sê? Ek wil vir haar kinders sê om net haar nagedagtenis in stand te hou. Because this is very important. Om wat sê vir julle na Psalm 78 die opskrif hiervan sê lesse uit die geskiedenis. Wanneer ons lewe, laat ons lewe 'n spoor agter. 'n Spoor vir iemand anders wat agterkom om in te trap. Vandag laat mami vir julle 'n spoor agter. Hierdie wonderlike mens, DJ Chesney Steven. En die pragtige kleinseun, vandag los sy vir julle 'n spoor na. En ook julle metgeselle. Hou daaraan vas. Hoor wat sê, skryf. Open met 'n spreek. Raaisels uit die voortyd. Don't forget it. Never forget it. Hy sê wat ons gehoor het en weet en ons vaders ons vertel het. Antimona gaan sê wat julle moeder julle vertel het van die Here Jesus Christus. Hy sê sal ons nie verberg vir hulle kinders nie, maar aan die volgende geslag vertel. Steven, jy vertel aan hom, as hy eendag getroud is, vertel hy aan sy geslag. En sy geslag, en so gaan het van generasie tot generasie. Wat vertel ons aan die volgende geslag? Die roemryke dade van die Here. Ons verberg dit nie, maar so gaan dit van die af die een geslag tot die ander geslag. Deur die genade van die Here is ek bevoorreg om my derde geslag saam met my in die huis van die Here te hê. My derde geslag. My kinders, my kindskinders, my, ek is al 'n ouma grootjie. En almal is saam met my in die kerk. Want ek het hulle geleer om in my spoor te trap. En die dag toe my man heen gaan, het hulle geweet, dit was die wet van God. Wat hulle oupa, hulle moet daarin bly. En die David sê, en ek oordink sy wet, dag en nacht. Don't forget it, my children. From today on, you are my children. No, the two of you are in Cape Town. My house become your house. If you need someone, Mamona is there for you. DJ, Antimona is just a phone call away. Phone Antimona. Desmond, I am here. Hy sê, die sesde vers, so dat die volgende geslag dit kan weet, die kinders wat gebore word, ons het dit reg gesê, dat hulle kan opstaan en vertel aan hulle kinders, wat? Die roemryke dade van die Here. Mag die Here julle seën, hierdie paar woorde tot u hart seën. En moenie hierdie tema wat ons vandag gaan verkondig in Vredenburg van Jorita se begrafnis, maak jou klaar om jou God te ontmoet. Want dit is 'n verwisseling wat plaasvind. Dis in daardie moment wanneer dit plaasvind, is die mees belangrikste oomblik ooit in ons lewe. Want ons moet weet hoe daardie verwisseling plaasvind. In wat vind die verwisseling plaas? In watter staat is ek myself? Is my lewe wanneer daardie verwisseling plaasvind? Het ek 'n ontmoeting met die Here persoonlik gemaak? Wanneer die verwisseling plaasvind van die een lewe tot die ander lewe. Want daar is 'n lewe na die dood. Daniël skryf dit. Daniël sê, Job sê, sal die mens lewe as hy gesterf het? Daniël sê, ja, sommige tot die ewige lewe en sommige tot die ewige verderf, vir ewig afgryslik. Die ewigheid hou twee dinge in. Die ewigheid hou of die hemel of die hel in. Daarom sê ons 4 vers 12. Maak jou klaar om jou God te ontmoet. Die Here seën u. Baie dankie vir Tesmin en die kinders vir hierdie wonderlike geleentheid, hoor. Die Here seën. Ja.
Dankie. Halleluja. Miklo, Esau. Say here, eldest brother. As kan dit maar met kort kan van geluk.
Good morning, everybody. I'm thankful for the opportunity to speak on the life of my sister. To Rita, Rita, as we called her, she really lived a well-balanced life. Of which she dedicated to her husband and her kids. She raised the three boys with deep-rooted Christian principles. Hulle was sterk in die kerk grootgemaak en 'n sterk hand oor hulle gehou. I just want to confirm that my parents instilled that Christian values in us. They made sure that we attend church, we read the Bible, we do the necessary to live a full spiritual life. And Rita lived a full spiritual life. As a child, during her childhood, she developed that love for the Lord, an unending love for the Lord. You could never separate her from God and godly principles. That was Jurita. We had a very special bond, the two of us. A lot of people already said all the good things. Every speaker that was here said the good things about her. She was a woman with the feet firm on the ground. Firm. And if she believed in something, she would live it out. That was Jurita. That principles was installed into her by our late parents. She always used to put other people before herself. That is one thing that she did. She will see to others' needs and put it before her needs. That is what she was. I really appreciate the last hours that we could spend with her. It's so valuable hours that we could spend with her until the time she passed on. Today I can thank the Lord for a life well lived. And those are the moments that we need to cherish. That is the lesson that we take out of her life. She lived a life well, spiritually, and in any ways. Therefore, I would like to say to my sister, Hambagahle, continue the good work where you are now. Bye, my sister.
Amen. Thank you very much. Okay, now I'm just going to jump back again to Claudette Iso, who's going to do the obituary for us before the pastor comes up to minister.
Passed away peacefully, surrounded by a sons, Chesney, DJ, a husband, Desmond, as well as her brothers and sisters on 6 April 2020. As her eldest son, Stephen, was on deployment and could not be there in person. However, due to the dreaded modern technology that we as the older generation love to criticize and berate, he was able to be with his mother via video call. And yes, sometimes I don't believe it, but I'm also part of that older generation. What a revelation. 6 minutes is too little time to put every story in context and what I am talking about when I mention something, as well as the friends of hers over the years. I have never met anyone with a strong faith as Jurita. We can all learn a lesson and tear a page out of her book of life on faith, love, and forgiveness. Jurita loved her husband Desmond with every fiber of her being. I was there, I know. She loved her son equally. Always love personalities and treat them and spoil them accordingly. My father always gave Jurita yellow roses, hence all the yellow roses, and houseplants that I have developed a love-hate relationship with, because when those houseplants got aphids, plant lice, I had to clean it, which was gross to do. I still gave Jurita, I hated them in my own house. And on Thursday, when I was at her house, I looked in the living room in the one corner, and I saw the plant thriving. It did put a smile on my face when I noticed it. Right before Stephen's birth, Desmond sent Jurita a massive fruit basket with avocados, which she loved, and yellow roses. I personally have planted yellow roses in my garden at home. Not because I have a love for yellow roses, I actually don't. But they were planted in honor of Jurita, a beautiful English rose called the poet's wife. I myself love a pink rose and anything with a pinkish, peachy shade. The poet's wife was such an apt name because Jurita had good writing skills and she used to write very good comprehensions in school. There are so many tales to tell about Jurita, but so little time, all of them true. From the traveling she did with Marsilia, aka Sheila, I've realized the children did not know your name is Marsilia because they all called her Sheila. Sheila and Jurita had a chance to meet Lionel Richie, believe it or not, in the 80s. I did not believe that story, but it was confirmed by a reliable source, my aunt. And which her children didn't know she did. A youth days at Christ the King, from the VCS trips she took with Miklo, the Friday night coffee bar meetings, the late night baking for the cake sale of GCV at the Moravian Church, the people who shared that memories with her are here today. I've seen quite a few of them. They all know who they are. From her first job experience with Felicity, and I know she hated her nickname, so I will not call her that. At Mr. Fish in Central. The only thing I will say about that job experience was that Felicity was not amused with Jurita. I'm not gonna expand why. Later on, myself and Jurita had such a good laugh about it. She had a good sense of humor, and there was many laughs over the years. From the yearly outings Jurita, Gloria, and I took with the children to the beach and Happy Valley, to the monthly shopping trips in Main Street, now Governor Becky, and the lunches we shared thereafter, the weekly, sometimes monthly dinners, the sisters, their husbands, and the children had at the long table Chesney have such fond memories of. Myrtle and Martin and their children always had a seat at that same long table. The memories made by Desmond, Jurita, our cousin Lorna, and her partner, who passed away as well, Marcus. The after Sunday lunch drives we took with the Cressida, we famously called the ship because of its size, and the car Felicity and her husband Sizzle was driving, we dubbed the push and fly, because we always had to push that car before it started, and then we all jumped in and we drive off. While the sisters, the children, and Sizzle did a lot of exploring with those motor vehicles, it can never be forgotten. We almost blew up Chesney Believe it or not, at Sardinia Bay Beach, with a gas bottle that caught on fire, a tale Chesney still remembers until today. And it just brings a lot of laughs when we talk about it. Jurita helped to... I helped Jurita to raise... Well, Jurita helped to raise me as a child. She did. I helped her to raise her three boys. I always loved them as my own. And they know that. So does Desmond. Everyone claimed Chesney is my favorite. Unless my exact words can be quoted to me, Stephen, I have never uttered those words. Rain, I have loved you as much as I have loved Chesney Stephen DJ, as you are my own child. Right at the end, the irony was not lost on myself and Desmond. When I was feeding Jurita soup, Desmond walked in and he said to me, I see you have a big baby now. We laughed right at that moment. Our lives, myself and Jurita's, has come to a full circle. I've dreamt of Jurita's death for the past 4 weeks prior to Desmond sending me a message. Last 3 weeks, Thursday. Every night, every time I close my eyes and I wake up, the dream just continued. So when Desmond sent that message, I knew it was bad news. Desmond did a video call. And when I saw Jurita, I knew it, and not weeks. I've said my final goodbye on Thursday. I had a private moment with Jurita. I think I'm one of the few that did manage to get that private moment. Jurita was defiant until the end. And while I was saying my goodbyes to her, she said to me, I'm not dead yet. At that moment, I smiled and I said to her, I can see we will be stubborn until the bitter end. I expected nothing less of her because that is who she was. After all, she's descendant of the most stubborn people I have known. Anna Maria Johnson Ruston Nee Johnson, Mona Esau Nee Ruston, and Solomon Ruston. And the Ruston family that I hear can vouch how stubborn they all are. It is definitely not a lie, I'm telling you. We all possess that same quality, if we can put it that way. Jurita's life was not always a bed of roses. Some people have treated her really badly and said extremely mean, hurtful, and spiteful things to her. She shed many tears, I know, because I was there for it all. This is not a finger-pointing moment, not at all. But those people knew exactly who they were. Despite all the hurt that was caused to Jurita, she could always find forgiveness in her heart. She truly have forgiven you all. We can all take another page from Jurita's book and truly forgive each other, respect each other, and be better human beings to each other. And here, I am speaking specifically to my own family. In conclusion, during our private moment, have asked me a couple of things, and I have vowed to attempt to do three things for her as her final wishes. One was to make sure that Desmond and the children eat to keep up their strength and in order to help her. That was the easiest one to fulfill. They all ate this week. I know I made sure of it. The second one was to make sure that the children are always fine in life. The third one was to try my best to unify my family. Like I said, number one, I fulfilled. Number two and three, I'm dealing with adults. And in order to succeed, it will require each and everyone's full participation. I am willing to fulfill Churita's wishes. Churita lives on through her children and grandchildren. Each one of them have a portion of her personality. And I know them better than they know themselves. I'm standing here, and now I'm going off script because the rest was scripted. Myself and Jurita and Gloria, to an extent, had very similar looks. And yesterday, Nathaniel looked at me and he said to me, "But Auntie Claudette, you look like Grandma." Yes. I do look like his grandma, and that's where the similarities stopped. I did love Jurita and her children the most. Thank you. Thank you.
At last. Bless the Lord. Can we stand and sing just one song this morning?
Oh Lord, my God. When I'm in awesome wonder, the world then sings my soul, my Savior God. How great
take your seat. I promise I will not be long, just a few minutes. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7 to 8. I think Maria touched on it. I have fought the good fight, finished the race, and kept the faith. At last, the champion's wreath that is awarded for righteousness is awaiting for me, says Churita. The Lord, who is the righteous judge, is going to give it to me on that day. He is giving it not only to me, but also to those who have set their hearts and waiting for his appearance. I have fought the good fight. I have kept the faith. Every speaker that spoke here this morning spoke about Churita, how she ran the race and she kept the faith. I say she kept the faith. And if there's the only one thing that the family, the husband and the sons can take home with them, is to keep the faith. The most important thing is keep the faith. Whatever giant you are facing, keep the faith. If you feel that you want to give up, keep the faith. Doesn't matter what happened, but just keep the faith. For the Bible says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Geloof is 'n vaste vertroue op die dinge wat ons hoop, 'n bewys van die dinge wat ons nie kan sien nie. So whatever you are facing, Chesney, Stephen, whatever you are facing, just keep the faith. Keep the faith. Matthew chapter 12 verse 20 says, a bruised reed he will not break, and smoking flax he will not quench. A geknakte reed sal hy nie verder breek, en 'n doffe lampen sal hy nie uitblus nie. I know what you are going through this morning. I've been there more than 3 years ago when I lost my wife, and I can assure you this morning, a bruised reed, he will not break further. And a smoking flax, he will not quench, because God is faithful. I say God is faithful. To Desmond and the children this morning, 1 Peter 5 and verse 7 says, throw all your anxiety on him because he cares about you. Romans chapter 8 verse 28 says, we know that God works all things together for good for the one who love him, for those who are called according to his purpose. God can turn every difficult and painful circumstances into something positive. When we listen to every speech here this morning, every tribute that was paid, we know that it's a life well lived. And this morning, as Churita says, I have ran the race and I've kept the faith. I've kept the faith. I've kept the faith. I have kept the faith. How many of us can keep the faith till the last moment? Because Churita kept the faith till the last moment. And if you want to give up, whether you find yourself in Cape Town, Johannesburg, or Durban, whatever you are facing, keep the faith. Keep the faith. Say, keep the faith. I don't know whom, there will be somebody in this week, and it will be nothing to do with the family and nothing to do with Churita. You will face something that is so much bigger than yourself, but be reminded about Saturday morning when I said, keep the faith. Whatever you are facing, whether it's in your finances, in your marriage, in your relationship with your wayward son, wayward daughter, in relationship brother to sister, keep the faith. Keep the faith. Keep the faith. I say keep the faith. Psalm 23 verse 4, David says, even when I go through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. When Brother Desmond spoke to me and he spoke about his wife's last days and how she kept the faith, she did not fear death because she said, even though I go through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. I shall not fear. For Isaiah 41 verse 10 says, don't be afraid, I am with you. Don't look around you, I am your God. I say so mooi in Afrikaans, wees nie bevrees nie, ek is met jou. Kyk nie angstig rond nie, ek is jou God. Ek versterk jou, ek help jou, ek red jou.
regterhand. Isn't that powerful? Wees nie bevrees nie, ek is met jou, sê die Here. Wees nie, kyk nie angstig rond nie, ek is jou God, ek help jou, ek red jou met my reddende regterhand. Don't be afraid, I'm with you. Don't look around you. I am your God. Amen. I'm reminded when Martha and Mary spoke to Jesus, they said to Jesus, the one that you love, the one that you love, the one that you love is sick. And Jesus, the Bible says, is sick. But Jesus tarried a few more days. And when Jesus eventually came to Mary and Martha, and then they said, Jesus, if you were here, our brother wouldn't have died. But you know what? This was an unwritten conversation. Jesus said to them, you know what, Martha, Mary, I'm glad I wasn't here. Because Martha, Mary, you know me as the provider. You know me as the redeemer. You know me as the healer. But Martha and Mary, I'm so much more than just a provider. I'm so much more than just a healer. I'm so much more than just a redeemer. I am the resurrection and the life. Ek is die opstanding en die lewe. I'm the resurrection and the life. I'm much more than just giving you a job and a tender. I'm much more than just healing you. Much more than just being your redeemer. I'm much more than just giving you money and cars and houses. I'm so much more than that. I am the resurrection and the life. That's why Paul says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Ek skaam nie vir die evangelie nie, want dit is 'n krag van God tot redding. I'm not ashamed. I heard my brother say that his sister and their family was raised in the church. The fear of the Lord. They were raised in the fear of the Lord. They lived by the word. And today, if Jurita could speak, she would have said, for me to live is Christ, to die is gain. Whether I live, whether I die, it's for the glory of the Lord. Of ek lewe, of ek sterwe, ek doen dit tot eer van die Here. So whether I live or I die, the Bible says to be absent in the body is present with the Lord. Absent in the body, present with the Lord. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Absent in the body, present be the Lord. Now Psalms 73 verse 26 said, my flesh and my heart may fail, but God is the strength of my heart, my portion forever. So family, Brother Desmond and children, your flesh may fail, but no, God is your strength. When you feel that you can't, you just sing. There's a song that Kirk Franklin sang. He says, I know that I can make it. I know I can stand. So the days that you feel you can't, you just know that you can. Because with Christ, I say with Christ, you are more than a conqueror. You are an overcomer. Paul says in Philippians 4 verse 13, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Brother Desmond, you will fail. All these people tomorrow, most of them will be gone. And next week there will be no more phone calls and WhatsApp, only but a few. But this one thing you must tell yourself, I, Desmond, can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Through Christ that strengthens me. Romans chapter 14 verse 8 says, if we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord. Hallelujah. There is something, Brother Greg, Pastor Grootboom, Pastor Klotta, good to see you, sir. There is something about this gospel. Let me share with you the secret. Today it's Jurita. Pastor Boba, there is someone under the sound of my voice, you are next. And we just don't know who it is. And you might say today, no high blood pressure, no cancer, no sugar diabetic, there's nothing wrong with me, I'm as fit as a fiddle. Maar die Here bo kan my kop vermoor, daar's iemand in hierdie plek vermoor. You are next, but you just don't know it. Amen. Our pastor from Cape Town said, Amos 4 verse 12, maak jou klaar om jou God te ontmoet. Maak jou klaar. Maak jou klaar om jou God te ontmoet. Psalm 116 verse 15 says, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. Precious. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. There will come a morning, there's a song that says, when upon the clouds of heaven, Christ shall come to earth again. Daar gaan 'n môre kom by die oorspoort, waar die dode, oud en jong, uit die graf sal opstaan. And that morning, Jurita will say to Des, I've made it. And there will come that morning when we meet again. Because surely, we will meet again. I'm landing up for 2 more minutes. I've got 14 points. I've lost my wife 3 years ago, and I'm writing a portion, writing it. But 14 points that I want to give to you, sir. This is not preaching. This is not a scripture. But this is what a man goes through when he loses his wife. So that a husband can understand and children will understand how it is when you lose a mother, a sister, a wife. It is important for you to understand the process of grieving is not important. The process of grieving that's important and necessary, not the understanding of it. In other words, you must understand the process. So in other words, the process is important, but you don't have to understand it. Does it make sense? The process is important, but you don't need to understand it. Number two, in grieving, there are no rule books. In grieving, there are no time frames. There are no judgments. Grief is as individual as a fingerprint. It means that you will grieve differently. Chesney will grieve differently. Stephen will grieve differently. Claudette will grieve differently. Vanessa will grieve differently. Because grieving is like a fingerprint. Everyone grieves in a different manner. Yours will be different. Their journey will be different. But it's going to be different. It's going to get different. Number four, grief is like the ocean. It comes on waves ebbing and flowing. Sometimes the water is calm, and sometimes it is overwhelming. In other words, Chesney, sometimes where you find yourself in Cape Town, it will be calm waters. But the next day you will feel like some days I don't want to get out of bed. Because some days will be calm, but some days will be very overwhelming. Number five, it's not important about getting over it. It's about learning to live with it. Not to get over it, but to learn to live with it. Many people spoke here this morning, and some of you were maybe irritated by one speaker that spoke longer than the other. And you said, but I've got things to do. But this is the last moment and last opportunity for this family to say goodbye to to a life long, a life lived well. And we need to be patient with one the other, even in this season. Grief changes us. There's something about when you grieve, we understand more deeply, hurts more often, appreciates more quickly, cries more easily, and we hope more desperately. I understand what Desmond and the family are going through this morning because I've been there, and there are many in the audience that have lost loved ones. And when you've lost a mom, when you've lost a sister, when you've lost a wife, you understand what they are going through this morning. Healing takes time. Desmond, just do the best you can. Just do the best you can. We never get over our loss. We absorb it. And that carve us into kinder creatures. In other words, God changes your heart. There's something when you lose a loved one, you're just a different person afterwards. You speak softer. You understand things different. There's a greater understanding. You don't have time for jealousy and envy. You don't have time to run after cars and money and material things. Because death changes us. We understand that we are here today, but tomorrow is not guaranteed. Tomorrow is not guaranteed. And let me shock you this morning, whether you're a chief justice, the president of the country, whether you're a teacher, whether you are a lawyer or an advocate this morning, surely death will knock at your door. Someday. It doesn't matter who you are today. Goodbyes, Chesney, are not forever. It is not the end. Goodbye simply mean I will miss you until we meet again. Number 10, death ends a life, not a relationship. She will always be your wife. She'll always be your mother. She'll always be your sister. So death ends life, but it does not end your relationship. She will always be your little sister. She'll always be your beautiful wife. She'll always be your kindest mother. She'll always be the best friend that you've ever had. We never lose the people we love. Even to death, they continue to participate in every act, thought and decision we make. Number 12, the sorrow we feel when we lose a loved one is the price we pay to have them in our lives. To Desmond and the children and the family, the greatest tribute this morning that we can give to Surita is to keep on loving. For if we stop loving, we too shall die. God bless you. Thank you.
Just before I get someone to do the, I think it's Claudette again that's going to do the vote of thanks. So not Claudette, yeah, it's Claudette. Chisling, little child, and Claudette that's going to do the vote of thanks. You know, I'm standing here and I'm thinking aloud that when we buy items at the grocery store, there's always a stamp on the bottle. We know that. We don't buy items that's expired. We get rid of it. I'm standing and I'm thinking aloud, is that, do we know Each one of us has got a expired date stamped on us. Just we don't know it when. The Bible says that God knows the hour, the minute, the second, the month of our departure. You just don't know when your expiry date will take place. I can so agree with the pastor when he ministered that. So we're going to ask the vote of thanks to be done, and then we'll proceed and start coming to a conclusion. Amen.
I didn't really prepare for the text without anything down because I wasn't sure how it would be when I get up here. But I do want to share something. Like, my mom's probably one of the strongest people that I've ever known. And she showed it right through her life to the end. Not once that she complained to us about how she was feeling, how sick she was. All she was saying positivity throughout. All she did was, I remember when we were just on the past 2 days before she left us, and I mentioned that she's sick, and she told me, Jasmine, we don't speak sickness into my life, we speak healing. And that just shows the type of person that she was, and the strength that she had, and the belief, and the faith. And for that, that is unparalleled. Nobody can match it. We can only love to be like my mom one day, or to show what she instilled in all of us. With that being said, I do feel I got a little bit stronger because everybody was worried I would be crying. But I just want to say, thank you for everybody that has come out today from far and near to celebrate my mom. These special thanks I want to say to my dad that's sitting over there. No one will know, we can tell you that what he went through or something, but not once we can understand how much strength it took from him to support my mom throughout that. I can only imagine looking at your wife and thinking, I can see that I'm sick, and there's nothing I can do to protect you. It's the most helpless feeling you can have as a man. And he had to watch that. I had to see my mom slip away, slowly but surely, but she kept the faith with us. And I just want to say thank you to my brothers. Mom loved us more than anything. More than anything, we were her life. No matter how angry we made her, it never changed. I want to thank my family that was here, especially in that last week. I know you guys didn't know much, but you guys came and supported her. And in her own way, she's very thankful for that. And I know how hard it was for everyone. I appreciate that. My brothers appreciate that. My father appreciates that. And I just want to say thank you from all of us. Another thing is the past year, our life changed a lot since we found out my mom was sick. We met a lot of new people came into our lives as well. For one, would be Shebi. Would be Nadia, who isn't here. You guys don't know the contribution Nadia has made to this as well. And for that, I want to thank her, and I hope she is watching. I want to thank Shevi for being there for my mom as well, and just talking to her, because she was around me. We don't talk much. So she enjoyed that. So I want to thank you for that. For Angelique, I know there were moments when you did come to us and you were chilling with my mom and you did a hey. I appreciate that. She appreciates that. Again, I just want to say thank you, everyone. I can't thank everybody, but I want to thank the family, the brothers and the sisters. You guys came together at the end for my mother. And I can't say, and I can't thank you enough for how much that means to us as a family, my brothers and my father. With that, I also wanted to say goodbye. Mom, you will be missed. And we hope to carry on your legacy for many more years to come. And thank you.
I'm just a sidekick. I do have assisted for the people he did not thank. From the family, we want to thank all the medical staff that attended to Jurita, both in Cape Town, Stellenbosch, St. George's Hospital, Kyler Clinic, Myrtle, the bread she made on Saturday morning after Jurita passed, and it was a house full of hungry people. Myrtle was there. Martin, for allowing his wife to stay out for so long with me since Thursday and not complaining once. For Myrtle, Martin, Keita, and Nicole for providing all the sweet snacks for today. For Revy and Nonny for providing the savory snacks. For my friend, my very best friend, Amshi Kupu, for food she sent. Esselin Borman, who's also a friend of mine, when I spoke to her about Jurita, everyone jumped to the party and they all wanted to come and help. Jurita unfortunately passed away before they could all be there. Lorna, our cousin from Cape Town. When I arrived on Thursday, I saw Desmond need Lorna, and I said, can I book you an air ticket? She said, no problem, I'll be there. Lorna arrived late, but I said to Lorna, it's hours, days, if we're lucky, Lorna. Okay? Let me just make sure down the list. Yes. And thank you for, anyway, for being the master of ceremonies for us here and for actually a program director. For the people at Christ the King that's assisting with the tea, we want to thank them. And Pastor Johnny, I know we're way over time. We owe you big time. I will try and make up. And thank you to everyone. Okay. To celebrate Jurita's life. I'm a firm believer, and I believe that. So it's not good until we meet again. Thank you, everyone. Oh, just after the church, we're moving to Papenskale Cemetery. For the burial there, and after that we're moving to Christ the King Church for some cakes, teas and snacks. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you for all of your patience, bearing with us, ensuring that everything been well and good. At any funeral, there's always the good, the bad, and the ugly. I want to conclude in saying, Saul, when he was in his good days, Bible says, he gave David a very tough time, pursued his life, angered him. David had to flee for his life. But when Saul died, David could have remembered the bad things of his life. Could have hated him for the bad that he had done to him. But at the funeral service at Saul's grave, David chose otherwise. He honored Saul by saying, "How the mighty have fallen." He slew thousands, and he was as swift as an eagle. He decided to speak the best of Saul. He decided to speak the best, even through the hardships he gave him. We have Jurita in front of us. Whether she gave you a hard time, tough time, ugly time, let us remember the best that came out of her. Many giants have fallen, and she's a great giant. Amen. The Bible said, let us not be hasty to judge. We don't know the end. Surely we don't know the end. God is a gracious God that we are serving. Amen. We're going to conclude in singing the hymn, "How Great Thou Art." And after that, we have the tribute playing out. Amen. Can we all stand and just sing "How Great We Are" thou art? And then the video tribute follows immediately.
Oh Lord my God, when I
this point in time that the video tribute to be played, and then also immediately the pallbearers out of the church, the Bow sisters, Tisha Bester, Marlene, Sammy, Vanessa, Abel, Sharon, Godfrey, Lynette, Barons, Phyllis Bow, and Denise Bow. Can we have them up coming at the same time? And then whilst we play that video tribute, Marvin Diamonds, I think they will play through the system. Thank you.
Philip.
God, I will come. Surely he shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence. He shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you shall take refuge. His wings shall be your shield and buckler. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but I shall not come to you. Only with your eyes shall you look and see the reward of the wicked. For you have made the Lord my refuge, even the Most High God your dwelling place. No evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling. For he shall keep his angels charge over you, and keep you all your ways. Their hands that shall bear you up, let your foot dash not against the stone. You shall tread upon the lion and the cobra, the young lion and the serpent you shall tread upon. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high because he has known me. He shall fall upon me and I will answer him. I will give him trouble. I will deliver him and honor him with long life.
Thank you. Behind you, they say something behind.
What?
Hey, let me.
Until death we part.
Ek sê nog net vir jy en jy kom ons maar weer.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.